Next component is throttling device. Okay, so what is the purpose of throttling device? So it is just a throttle valve. Okay, it is just a valve. What is the purpose of valve? It is used to open and close the fluid flow. For example, we are using a valve in water taps. Water tap is also a valve. Okay, what is the purpose of water tap? It is used to open and close the fluid flow. Here also the same purpose that we are using here. At this point, for example, I'm going to highlight a opening port here. So it is the opening area that differs from inlet and outlet. Okay, so here it is a handle. The handle is used to raise the valve or lower the valve. So while raising the valve, the fluid flow get opened, so there will be a fluid flow while raising the valve. Okay, there will be a fluid flow. It is also a insulated component, so that is what represented here. There is a spiral coil wound around the throttle valve. Okay, so the purpose of spiral coil is it is a insulation material. So the purpose of insulation is used to not to transfer the heat. Okay, here also Q is equal to zero, and also with that the valve will not produce any work. Okay, so due to that we can write W is equal to zero. Due to that W is equal to zero. Here also we can see that the inlet is mentioned in the notation called 1, and the exit is mentioned in the notation called 2. Okay, there may be a difference in inlet and outlet pipe. For example, there may be a diameter difference in the inlet and also exit, but what is the height of the inlet and exit? That is what we have to know. So with this we can able to find out what is the potential energy. So height is height will create a potential energy. So what is the height of 1 and 2? It contains the same height. For example, Z1 is equal to Z2. Okay, it contains the same height. For example, throttling device is also a cylindrical component. So the axis for the throttling device is same. It is horizontal line. So due to that, we can write Z1 is equal to Z2, or we can write Z1 minus Z2 is equal to 0, or Z2 minus Z1 is equal to 0. Okay, so we are going to derive a formula for throttling device from a basic equation. Okay, so just remember we have insulated a throttling device. Due to that Q is equal to zero. Okay, due to that Q is equal to zero, because it is fully insulated, there is no heat transfer here. And also with that it is a throttling device, so the work will not get produced in throttling device. Okay, so we can write W is equal to zero. Okay, change in potential energy is zero. That is called Z2 minus Z1 or Z1 minus Z2. Potential energy is that mean there is a difference of height. If there is a difference of height, I am sure that there will be a potential energy. But here it is a throttling device. It is a cylindrical device. The axis for this device is horizontal. So due to that we can write Z2 minus Z1 is equal to zero. So the formula is same like our previous method. H1 plus V1 square divided by 2 is equal to H2 plus V2 square divided by 2. So it is the same formula derived in nozzle and diffuser. But here the change in kinetic energy is negligible. Okay, so the purpose of nozzle and diffuser is used to create a kinetic difference in kinetic energy. That is called V2 get increased, or V1 get V2 get decreased in nozzle and diffuser. But here it is a throttling device, so it is used to open and close the fluid flow. That's it. So there is no kinetic energy difference. So change in kinetic energy is zero in this throttling device. That means v1 minus v2 is equal to 0. Velocity 1 minus velocity 2 is equal to 0. So there will not be any kinetic energy change. So due to that, we can write v2 minus v1 is equal to 0. So the total term will get becomes h1 is equal to h2. Okay. There may be a negligible difference. So in some problems, they may give a value for velocity 1 and also velocity 2. So in that conditions, you can use the previous formula, h1 plus v1 square by 2 is equal to h2 plus v2 square by 2. So in a throttling problem, if they give a value, so you can use this formula, or you can use h1 is equal to h2 in a throttling device. So what is called h? It is enthalpy. So enthalpy at inlet is equal to enthalpy at outlet. That is the formula for throttling device.